Good morning, and welcome to the Cathedral of Our Lady of Victory as we celebrate the 16th Sunday in Ordinary Time.
Come together as Christ's body. Let's prepare ourselves for these sacred mysteries. Let's call to mind our sins. Let's ask for God's pardon and peace. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have erred and sinned in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done, in what I have committed to you, through my fault,
through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May the Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Oh,
And let us pray. Show favor, O Lord, to your servants, and mercy increase the gifts of your grace, that made fervent in hope, faith, and charity, they be ever watchful in keeping your commands. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord appeared to Abraham by the terebinth of Mamre, and he sat at the entrance of his tent while the day was growing hot. Looking up, Abraham saw three men standing nearby. When he saw them, he ran from the entrance of the tent to greet them, and bowing to the ground, he said, "Sir, if I might ask you for this favor, please do not go past your servant. Let some water be brought, that you might bathe your feet, and then rest yourselves under the tree. Now that you have come this close to your servant, let me bring you a little food, that you may refresh yourselves, and afterward, you may go on your way." The men replied, "Very well, do as you have said." Abraham hastened into the tent and told Sarah, "Quick, 3 measures of fine flour, knead it and make rolls." He ran to the herd, picked out a tender choice steer, and gave it to a servant, who quickly prepared it. Then Abraham got some curds and milk, as well as the steer that had been prepared, and set these before the 3 men. And he waited on them under the tree while they ate. They asked Abraham, "Where is your wife Sarah?" He replied, "There in the tent." One of them said, "I will surely return to you about this time next year, and Sarah will then have a son." The word of the Lord. Second reading is a letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. "Brothers and sisters, now I rejoice in my sufferings for your sake, and in my flesh I am filling up what is lacking in the afflictions of Christ on behalf of his body, which is the church, of which I am a minister, in accordance with God's stewardship given to me, to bring to completion for you the word of God, the mystery hidden from ages and from the generations past. But now it has been manifested to his holy ones, to whom God chose to make known the riches of the glory of his mysteries among the Gentiles. It is Christ in you, the hope for glory. It is he whom we proclaim, admonishing everyone and teaching everyone with all wisdom, that we may present everyone perfect in Christ. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus entered a village where a woman whose name was Martha welcomed him. She had a sister named Mary who sat beside the Lord at his feet listening to him speak. Martha, burdened with much serving, came to him and said, "Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me by myself to do the serving? Tell her to help me." The Lord said to her in reply, "Martha, Martha, you are anxious and worried about many things. There is need of only one thing. Mary has chosen the better part, and it will not be taken from her." The Gospel of the Lord. Martha and Mary were close friends of Jesus, and they had a great relationship with him. They lived in Bethany outside of Jerusalem, which is probably where Jesus and the disciples stayed when they went there. In Mary's relationship with Jesus, she felt the desire to sit beside Jesus at his feet and listen to him. The gospel does not say much more about Mary except that she has chosen the better part, and it will not be taken from her. This sounds like a gift, something given in such a way that would not even be possible to take back. Like trust, honesty, selfishness, selflessness, commitment, intimacy, and true friendship. Martha, burdened with much serving, came to him and said, "Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me by myself to do the serving? Tell her to help me." Martha had such a relationship with Jesus that she could openly address her needs and even make the statement to Jesus to tell Mary to help her. We've probably heard similar things in our own families. Mom, tell Joey to give me back my toy. Joey, give your sister back her toy. But Mama, I want to play with it. You know, and the story goes on. Jesus' response today was more than a mediator or a parent. His words to Martha are not really a reproach. Rather, they are a warm praise for Mary's interest in hearing our Lord speak. St. Augustine explains that the former busied herself, the latter got nourished. The former had things to attend to, the latter concentrated on one. Both occupations were good. Martha is often seen as a symbol of the active life, and Mary as a symbol of the contemplative. We know that there are different vocations within the church, but both action and contemplation are to be found in every Christian life. We who are baptized are called to have an integrated life in which our personal relationship with God merges pleasantly with our responsibilities. The life of the Christian witness can only be seen through the charity of the heart. Words alone, work alone, busyness, strife, cannot be the way of love, nor can apathy and complacency ever merit loving works. A high-ranking government official once said to St. Mother Teresa of Calcutta, "You are doing social work, and we also do the same. But we are doing it for something, and you are doing it for someone." To do our work, we have to be in love with God. To learn, to listen, to contemplate the life of Christ is to learn how to better love our neighbor. If we are not learning from the master lover, then where are we learning to love? Who is our teacher? If life's busyness consumes us and we do not give time to sit at his feet, we are failing to love. Maybe we can even say that our loving action toward our neighbor, family, or friends is only comparable to the time we spend with our Lord. What actions we think to be loving are often given in response to someone's needs if it seems convenient for us or it makes us feel good about ourselves. Christ is calling us to a sacrificial love that urges us to be holy and to learn from him. So how do we do God's work? Trying to feed a group of more than 15 people was a major task for one person. Martha feels that her sister should have shared the load. The Lord said to her in reply, "Martha, Martha, you are anxious and worried about many things. There is need of only one thing. Mary has chosen the better part, and it will not be taken from her." Jesus reminds her and us that there is a priority in life. Listening to the word of God, as there is a great hunger in one's heart for truth. This comes prior to sharing in the preparation of a meal. Both are good, but one is greater. As we do God's work, we're often confronted with not so much the how, but the why. We have filled our lives and thoughts with how much there is to do, that often we cannot even do what needs to be done. Anxiety is what drives us and is sadly the very thing that sucks us dry and leaves us empty. What causes us anxiety? What is the real issue underlying our anxiety? And what was it for Martha? In this life, The contemplation of the supernatural reality, the grace, the action of grace working in our souls, our love for our neighbor as a result of our love for God, is the work and the foretaste of heaven. And we can grow from this day by day if we accept the work. We Christians cannot resign ourselves to leading a double life. Our life must be a strong and simple unity in which all our actions converge. Martha has a portion of the good work, the good in her work of providing meal. Yet anxiety and the pressure consumed her efforts, and she became disillusioned to think she was the only source of work being done. Anxiety led to a selfish attitude. What started out as a selfless act of service became a burden and drained from her the life-giving love through her sacrifice. So what is our priority in our daily life? This priority can be found good when we ask, how is it serving others? And ultimately, is it flowing from the desire to love God first? How much quality time do we spend listening to the Lord? The time put into listening and learning of God and the beauty of the Catholic faith will result in a peaceful and truly happy life. How much time do we spend doing these things, things even for the Lord? This is a direct reflection of our friendship with Him. We all know that the fruit of any relationship is possible only from the amount of love and energy put into it. The wonderful peace prayer of St. Francis says it all. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. And where there is sadness, joy. He would go on to say, for it is in giving that we receive, and it is in pardoning that we are pardoned. These things are what we can do every day at work, at home, school, on the sports field, anywhere. All can be accomplished, but first we must be filled by our time spent with Jesus and the love and wisdom that can only come from Him. This is the only way to learn to be all that you are created to be, to live a life of full and vibrant beauty, a life of no regrets. Enjoying the good fruit of heaven is to be found in your time spent with Jesus, a life of true and unfailing hope. Doing God's work is serving Him in and from the ordinary, material, and secular activities of human life. There is something holy, something divine hidden in the most ordinary situations, and it is up to each of us to discover it.
Our faith. I believe in one God.
Suffered death and was buried, and
proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection day and the life of the world to come.
As Martha and Mary discovered, the kindness and love of God is revealed in Jesus in our midst. Let us pray to God who is here, the God who listens.
For the Holy Catholic Church, may her sacred liturgy enrich the personal prayer of those who assemble for worship. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For immigrants, refugees, those seeking asylum, and all who migrate in search of safety, security, and well-being, may they find welcome in their new homes. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer in the summer's extreme temperatures, especially seniors and those with difficult medical conditions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For beneficial rain to our area, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish family, may we, like Mary of Bethany, listen to Christ in times of silent reflection. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for the repose of the souls of Alejandro and John Briones, and for all the faithful departed, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the needs listed in our parish intention book, and for those we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Ever-loving Father, receive our prayers as we rejoice in the mystery of Christ among us, for he lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you. pray, friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all the Church.
O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion varied offerings of law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants, and make it holy as you bless the gifts of Abel, so that each is offered to the honor of your majesty, may benefit for the salvation of all, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and ever give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and you make them holy. And you never cease to gather people to yourself, so from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which he poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." History of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, in recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may attain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Brennan, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you gain for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you summon before you. Hear your compassion, O merciful Father. Gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, who all are pleasing to you at their passing in this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. That we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom we bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And now, through Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be freed from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not in our sin, but in the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
thank you.
And let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.